Hey, what's going on, guys? So it's been a while. It's been a bit hectic. I did say I was going to do a live stream doing Underwater for the Easter egg hunt. Things have been really crazy. As you can see, I look a little bit different, full of new tattoos, so it's been a little bit crazy. I've had a look around a little bit to see what I could find, and to be honest, there isn't that much stuff underwater, but there is some places to explore. Now we're going to head down here. There's quite a few little bases that we need to cover on the underwater part, so the stream will probably last, I'd say, an hour, maybe a little bit less, but we'll see how we get on. So let's go. So we'll head over to this one first, one of the little ones. To be honest, most of the Easter eggs on the game haven't been sort of on the bases, but I'm still going to have a look, and I'm just going to sort of go underwater as much as I can to see what we can find. And there was one Easter egg already found underwater, and that was the rubber ducks that sort of pop out. If you haven't seen that one, definitely check out my other videos. That's pretty cool. And we found some zombies and stuff as well. Again, if you haven't seen them, definitely go check it out. But yeah, we're going to see what we can find. Now, apparently there's some sort of unsunken ship or something that I haven't found yet. I think it's supposed to be around near the main base. There's supposed to be an underwater sort of statue or something as well, which again I haven't seen, but we'll see how we get on. And since we found the shark last time, the great white shark, you never know, we might come across something else underwater as well. Hey, what's up, guys? How's it going? Oh, hopefully it won't take too long to get over here. I hate riding around on the sea in boats because it's so slow. But then again, I forgot. I might as well just use my jetpack and then die. Fail. Nice. Come on. I've not played it in that long that I'm forgetting the controls, so it's a little bit annoying. Come on, get on the boat. Get on the boat. I actually forgot what was my boost, but now it's telling me. Hold circle. There we go. We're going a little bit quicker. Where's the bad guys? Oh, there they are. Oh, I'll just kill you. Right, so we'll start on this base. Well, sort of a mini base. And then we'll go under the water and just see what we can find. Because most of the deep bits, to be honest, there is nothing really at the bottom, and by the time you do get down there, you've kind of ended up running out of air, so you start dying. But any of you guys spot anything that looks sort of out of place, we'll definitely check it out, as long as we don't die, which I can see us doing quite a lot in this one. I was looking for a cheat so we could kind of try and survive underwater for a bit. There's supposed to be a god mode, but I haven't managed to get it working. I don't know if it's just me. Yeah, it's out for everyone now. It's been out for quite a while. So on this base, while we're under the water, you can see there's nothing really there. You can't even see the bottom. I'm going to go down a little bit further just to see what happens. See if we can even see the bottom. Which at the moment, you can see you can't. And we're going to start dying. Come on, get out, don't die. There we go. Right, let's see which base to head to next. So if we go to this one, we can kind of go in and out of the water along the way and see if we can find anything. All right, so we'll just keep sort of diving under. Yeah, I've seen it. To be fair, I don't know if I'm going to get it though, the PS4 Pro. I was expecting it to kind of have exclusive games and stuff. If it did, then I would have definitely got it. But to be honest, just for the graphics wise, I don't really want to spend that much money just to improve the graphics, because I'm going to need a new TV as well. But I'm looking to get a 65 inch curved one at some point, but I don't know when just yet. So I think I'm going to wait until I've got that, and then hopefully there will have been a price drop or something as well, so I'll probably pick it up then. It looks massive. That's the only other thing that's putting me off, the size of it. I saw a picture where it's sort of next to the PS4 and the PS4 Slim, and it looks huge. Yeah, I need to get a 4K. The one I've got at the minute, I've got just a standard HD 60-inch LED thing, which is pretty cool. But it's not 4K, so I need to get one. Yeah, well, I'm based in the UK, so I think it worked out at £350, which isn't too bad, to be honest. So if they do drop it, you'll probably get it sort of around the same price with a couple of games bundled in, or £300. They'll probably do a little bit of a drop, but probably not too much. It's only sort of a month after it comes out. So for underwater Easter egg hunting, like I say, it is pretty difficult because on most parts the ocean is too deep to be able to get down. So we're going to sort of be going around the bottom of the bases, because parts of the bases are sort of submerged underwater. So I'm thinking if there is anything, that's where it's going to be. Whereabouts in the UK are you from, dude? And take off. Whee. And then we'll get under the water.
Attention all units. Target's escaping. Do not let him get away.
Right, so there's all sort of these little bits. Cool, I'm based in Manchester. It's pretty cool, but the only thing is you can't do a constant boost. You just can't do it twice. So it lets you sort of move out of the water a little bit quicker. Is that a shadow or am I seeing things? Yeah, I'm seeing things. Whereabouts in the US you from, dude? I'm looking to visit America in next year, hopefully. Looking to do a nice road trip. So, doesn't really look like there's much down here, but definitely we need to have a look. I'm sure there'll be something. Nice. That's where my missus wants to go. She wants to go swim with dolphins and go Disneyland and stuff. Right, so we've got the main bit of the base that's submerged over here. To be honest, with all the DLCs, they have only sort of put a couple of Easter eggs in each one. They haven't kind of added loads, which I was a little bit disappointed in. But at least there's something to search for, because you know there's going to be a couple added in. The only one that I didn't find any Easter eggs for was the Sky Fortress DLC. But at some point I'm going to have a proper look around again and maybe do another live stream. Yeah, I watched the announcement yesterday. It said about the 1080p, but it didn't seem to improve things that much. It was just the textures were a little bit better. To be honest, if I do get it, I think it's going to be more for the PlayStation VR, because they said it was going to kind of double the capabilities of it, and that seems pretty cool. But to be honest, I think that's about it. Right, so we haven't found anything on this base. We have already searched all on top of all the bases and stuff. Let's have a look over here. So which way do we need to go? That way. Hopefully, nope, we did. I was just gonna say, hopefully we don't smash our heads in, but too late. Right. So again, we'll do the same kind of thing and just sort of duck under the water. If we see any shallow bits, because that's where most of the Easter eggs tend to be. The last Easter egg, which one? The last live stream that I did, we found a great white shark. We found like some zombies and stuff. Yeah, I saw that as well. So if you've got HDR on your TV, you kind of get the benefits of it as well. The only difference is the resolution. like I say, the main part for me, if I do get the Pro, is going to be for the PlayStation VR, because the games are going to look crazy on it. Not too sure how it's going to work out for YouTube or not. I'm not sure if you're going to be able to stream and stuff, but hopefully you can. Yeah, cool, dude. I've done a couple. This is the third one that I've done. We found a few Easter eggs messing around. People kept asking me to do an underwater one, so I thought I'd give it a go. I was looking for a cheat so we didn't die and we could sort of stay underwater, but I didn't manage to find one that worked. Yeah, I pre-ordered mine the first day it came out. Can't wait for it. The demo disc sounds pretty cool, so you get to try out, like, I think it's 8 games. So you get to kind of try before you buy. Thing I'm most looking forward to, though, has got to be the, I think it's, is it called cinematic mode or something? So you can kind of play all your normal games. Oh, we're in a shallow bay. What's down here? Nothing. Come on, don't die. Don't die. Thank you. I know we're gonna get shot to death instead. All units, we are being engaged. With the PS4 Pro, it is the on the stream thing that they did yesterday on the announcement. They kind of said that it's gonna support it, and it looks pretty cool. Rise of the Tomb Raider as well, supposed to have a PS4 Pro only mode, which definitely sounds cool. But I think it'd be better if they did some exclusive games for it. Oh, for VR, that'd be cool. Like a zombies mode. Zombies in VR, that'd just be scary as hell. So when I'm under the water, I'm kind of looking for like crates and stuff, or just anything that looks out of place rather than just a copied texture. Right, so we'll get out of the water for a little bit so we don't die and see if there's anything under the base. If any of you guys missed the last underwater Easter egg, or well, the first one that we found, the rubber ducks, I'll show you that one in a minute as well, because that one was pretty cool. And it's not really one that you'd find unless you did go looking for it. Yeah, someone told me there's supposed to be a shipwreck around as well. I think, if anything, that'll probably be around near the main base. But at least we found a little bit of a shallow bit, so we can kind of see if there's anything down there. Only problem is, we have to keep swimming back up, so it is a little bit difficult. So I'm just going to see if I can kind of spot anything that looks out of place. You could kind of imagine them doing like Finding Nemo Easter egg or something. That'd be pretty cool. But I doubt it. Come on, stop shooting me. Because they have done quite a bit of work on the stuff underwater, you would have thought they'd have given you a better way to kind of explore. I thought with a sea heist, they would have given us some kind of scuba gear or a submarine or something. I was a little bit disappointed that they didn't. And I died. Do you mean in the shipwreck? Because we'll definitely have a look and see what we can find. And I've just noticed I've still got a message on the screen saying starting in 5 minutes. I'm not too sure, to be honest, because most of the Easter eggs in GTA 5 have kind of already been found. A lot of them are quite subtle as well. I might do, though. I do play GTA quite a bit, but I don't tend to stream it or do many videos on it, just because the amount of people out there that do the same kind of thing. There's not many people that kind of do stuff on Just Cause, which is why I like to show off some of the content. Cool, hopefully we can find it. Right, well, that bit didn't really have much, so we'll leave that bit for now. If we check out this bit first, where was... Oh, this has got quite a few shallows. Right, where should we go then? Awesome. Right, so on this bit, we'll kind of start over here and we'll just kind of swim towards the base over there and see if we find anything. So what's this Easter egg that you found? What's it relate to? I can't see anything here. Again, it does look pretty much just copy and paste textures. Swim up and get some air. And then down. I need to get the game on PC so I can try and do a mod just to empty all the water out so we can have a proper look around. But at the moment, nothing looks out of place. So it might have just been a one-off, the Easter egg that I found last time. And to be honest, I think we found about 5 Easter eggs altogether on this DLC. So if we didn't find anything else, it wouldn't be a major surprise. Right, so there's another base over here. And some more shallow bits. We'll have a quick look and then we'll check the underneath of that base. If I miss the shipwreck and any of you guys spot it, definitely leave a comment and let me know and I'll head back and check it out. Hey, what's up, dude? No. At least on this one, I'm not going to save the main base till the end. I'm just going to kind of go across as soon as I come to it. So I think that one will be next. Hopefully that's where we'll find some stuff. Only problem is, I always end up dying when I'm under the water there. Especially when you're trying to look around as well, it is pretty difficult. But nothing looks out of place, there aren't any containers or anything. But little bits like this, let's get up and see if we can find anything. Alright. Can't even get underwater. Go on, swim down. So there's nothing on this bit. Yeah, definitely. I'll be doing pretty much all the new games that are out this year. I'll be doing Mafia, I'll be doing Battlefield, Watch Dogs, covering all Easter eggs, all that sort of stuff, just seeing what cool stuff we can find. Might do a couple of live streams just playing the games as well, since it's supposed to be really cool. and like how to's, that sort of stuff, unlockables. Right, with all this junk that's down here, hopefully there's something down there. If there is, hopefully we spot it. It's pretty difficult to control under here. Yeah, it looks cool. Hopefully they've changed the driving thing on it. The driving annoyed me a little bit on the last one. Go on, swim through there. Don't die. I think this is where one of the Eden tapes were. So I don't think there'd be any kind of Easter egg here. But if we can jump around, we'll have a look. No. Alright, so there's nothing on this bit. Let's see if we can find any other bits we can go into. Something down there. We'll have a look at that in a second. Looks like a dead end though. I saw the Watch Dogs things with a PS4 Pro yesterday. That looked really cool. The graphics on it looked amazing. Yeah, hopefully. I did like the last one. I like the fact that you could kind of set your speed limit and stuff. I'm a little bit of a sad ass when I play a game sometimes. I'll kind of drive at the speed limit so it takes me for ages to finish a game. I did it with GTA 5, stopping at all the red lights and stuff. They're pretty funny. Until you go on a massacre. No, I thought there might have been something here. Yeah, I think it's pretty cool. Just a different way to play. Well, to be fair, when it came out on PS3, that's what I did. And then I got it on PS4 and I just went around like a psycho. Right. So we've done that one, we've done that one. Yeah, I think we'll go across here and then kind of come down. I might do that main base and then come back up. Yeah, we'll have a look at the main base. Because if there is anything, I presume that's where it's going to be. Where shall we dive in? How about now? See if we spot anything down here. Doesn't look like there's any shallow bits too much anyway. I don't see any crates and stuff. I really want to find this shipwreck though, because it sounds cool. Ooh, what's this? Cool. Trevor's got to be my favourite character. It's awesome when you swap to him and he's like at the top of a mountain, just sat there in his undies, throwing up in a bush or in a dress. So this one's got a lot of these bits, but again, I think they are just all copied textures. Because none of them have anything that you can get inside by the looks of things. This one's got something underneath it. Is it anything different? I thought it might have been some kind of secret tunnel or something then. Right, let's get back up before we die. Let's see whereabouts we are on it. Right, so we're up here. We'll head down to this bit and kind of go around, and we know that we finish at the top then. So fly a little bit and then dive. I mean, there's all these little bits on here on the sides of them. But I don't think I've ever seen one that's any different than the other. But to be fair, because they haven't added any proper ways of exploring underwater, I think that's why it is just copy textures. My favourite Easter egg, all of gaming. That's a hard one. Probably Battlefield 4 with a Megalodon, that's pretty cool. And like the Phantom stuff. Anything over here? No. Shoot back up. What about you? What's your favourite? I'm going to stay on the outside of the base at the moment, underwater. Ooh. Is this the shipwreck? It looks like it. I wonder if you can get inside. I think we need to go up first and get some air and then come back and explore. Right, so if we start at the back of it. Yeah, I like the bunnies. Are they called cabots? Is that the one that you mean? That are kind of just randomly dotted about. Because I know they're in the new Saints Row as well. Saints Row Get Out of Hell and that. Hopefully we can find a way in here, and it's not, again, not just a kind of copied texture thing. Right, so we're on this side. Need to remember where we are. Nice. On this, if there's an Easter egg, I presume it'd be like a sign or something. So let's read what they say. I presume that means equipment storage. No, don't die, don't die, don't die. No. Thank you. The only problem with doing the underwater Easter eggs, it takes forever and it's really difficult to find stuff. Right, so we've done that side, let's shoot back up and then we can kind of come back down and have a look on the top of it. Where'd it go? Oh, there it is. Come up a little bit just so we can see if there's any kind of doorways we can get in. Doesn't look like it. Alright, we'll have a look down the other side. If we can't find a way in, we'll just carry on having a look underneath the base. Can we not go through here? Ooh, what's this? Can we go in? No. Thought that was going to be our way in then, but it's not. What about this one? Nope. We are going to die, so let's get up if we can. No, we died. No. Never mind, I know where we are. I think. Come on. Hate loading screens. I need to get rid of that little 5 minute thing at the bottom. I forgot to take it off before. Let's get it off. There we go. Alright, where are we? Alright, so that's where the boat thing was. Shouldn't take us too long. Cheers, dude. I need to start being more active on Twitter. To be fair, it's mostly just my videos and stuff that you see on there, and the odd comment and stuff. What's that? Oh, it's a little base. Right, let's dive. I think this is where it was. Hopefully I'll be able to find it again. Where's the boat thing? Oh, I see a light. I think it's a light. Probably not. Right, where are we? I know we're around here somewhere. Oh, we've got some ruins. Ah. Some more creepy little things here. Right, I need to remember where we are. Right, so just underneath there. There's a few of them. With the last DLC, there was another one that was kind of hidden in a secret door that's got the same markings on. Need to try and see if I can get the markings on these. If I can get in the right place, I can take a screenshot later. So I don't mind if I die on this. As long as I get a clear picture, I'll be able to come back and have a look at it later on YouTube. Right. Yay, we died. So maybe that's something related to the other DLC on the Metland Assault on the other island. Maybe. But let's carry on going round. Still got quite a bit to cover. Done most of this. Because it's like 40 minutes now, I might just do the kind of the top half and come down to the bottom half another time. We'll see how we get on. Take off. Yay. So at least we found something. We found them obelisks, I think they're called. Which I haven't seen underwater ones before, especially since they've got candles on them, which is a bit odd. So we'll carry on going round till we get back to the top, have a look underneath, see if we find anything. Come on, give me my boost back. Yeah, so they're in there. I did a thing a while ago. I used to do a gaming Mythbusters show. I've not done it in a while. But I tried doing the mech underwater. You do still die, it just takes a little bit longer. I think it gives you like twice as much time, but it's still pretty slow. So you can't swim really fast to explore. It's not too bad just for getting away from like bad guys and stuff, but doing this kind of stuff, it is a little bit too slow. Still pretty cool though. I see a strange shadow. Another shipwreck. Let's go back up. Come on. Right, where are we? Nice. I haven't had time to do one in quite a while. They do take quite a lot of time for the gameplay and the editing and stuff. Plus, to be fair, until some new games come out, it's trying to find enough content to cover as well. There aren't any air pockets or anything in here. We're gonna die. Let's get back up. No. We died again. It's pretty cool. It's fun to do. It's fun to test all the stuff out. It's just, like I say, I covered most of the decent games that were out at the time. I did like The Division and all that sort of stuff. At the moment, there aren't that many new games out that I play, and I play No Man's Sky, but just because of the way that it's set up, it's pretty difficult to find the content to do for it. Where was that ship? Oh, it started us all the way up there. Nice. What I used to do, I used to put a thing on my Facebook and gaming groups on Facebook, basically asking people to give me myths to test out for games that they either did have or didn't have, that sort of stuff. That were pretty cool. That's where I used to find most of mine, just getting other people to give me them to test out, which is pretty good, to be fair, because it kind of gets the community involved as well. I'm not going to be able to find this boat again now. Right, we'll come back to it. Right, so we kind of head over here and then we'll come back under. Like I say, to be fair, all the bases that I've covered and when I've explored around messing around, there's been nothing underneath them at all, apart from this main base. So I think this is going to be the main one that I focus on. But again, it is all just pretty much copied textures. Oh, little light under there. I think that's just the entrance into the main thing. That's where we're now. Yeah, that's why I started doing them, to be fair. When I get a new game, I always like, when I get a bit bored, I like just having a look at what random stuff's been put in them. And when I started looking for Just Cause Easter eggs and stuff, I couldn't really find any at first. They were just kind of the same, like, three or four Easter eggs that people put on. But I'd found more myself, so I thought I'd start doing a bit of content on it. And to be fair, that's when I started doing the YouTube. If you check back through all my videos, I think one of my first videos was Just Cause. So I only really started my channel up, I think it was October last year. I think I did like three videos before Just Cause came out, but it's going cool. I do really hope they do a season pass part two though. Right, so on the outside of the base, underwater, there's the underwater obelisk things, but that's pretty much it. So we'll have a look underneath the base and see what's under here. But I always die under here, so bear with me. I think we need to get some air. And then we'll see what we can find. To be fair, I'm not really sure whether that's good or bad. I'm not sure sort of the average sort of growth of YouTube channels. But I'm enjoying it. I'm not doing it just to get loads of subs and stuff. I do it just because I think it's fun to do. It's just a hobby. Nice. I remember when I first hit 100, it was crazy. No, I'm gonna die. Come on, get up. Good boy. And down you go. Cool. What's with the floating barrel? You can't even use your weapons underwater, which is a little bit annoying as well. It's kind of these floating barrels that I thought maybe might do something. Yeah, to be fair, a lot of people, it's kind of just trying to find content to put out there. Hey, what's up, dude? When I was doing it, I was trying to put on one video every single day. But if you're trying to do daily content on the same kind of game, sometimes you can end up putting videos on that people aren't interested in. So that's why I've kind of moved it to sort of maybe three or four videos a week, just to try and get some decent content on there. So we'll have a couple more dives under here because we keep dying and... Throw a grenade from land, as in from up here. I'll give it a go. Nope, wrong button. Can always tell when I've not played a game in a couple of weeks because I start pressing the wrong buttons for controls. Let's just toss some down here, see if it does anything. I didn't think of that. We'll grapple, see what it does when I bring it up. Try bringing them up, see if it does anything. Oh, that one's disappeared. We'll bring this one up and see if it does anything. We'll shoot it. If it moves. No, it's got stuck. Yeah, it's got full on stuck. Oh, that one's there. No, it don't do anything. Never mind, I thought it might do. Floating around randomly. See if we can find. No, that's going back out. So where the shark cage thing were, I think it's just over here. Still haven't seen it apart from when you sort of inside the base. Would be pretty cool if there was something to trigger it out here. But to be fair, it doesn't look like there is. Just have another quick swim around. Nope. Yeah, that'd be cool, dude. I'll give you a shout out. So have you got a channel yourself? What sort of content do you do? Right, so we've done these ones. I think I'm going to do these two. And then I might do another video maybe tomorrow and cover the bottom ones. Just because, like I said, around the bases, to be fair, apart from the main base, I haven't found anything on any of them. And this is the third stream I've done on it. So it's like 3 hours, and all the Easter eggs that have been found haven't been on any bases or directly underneath them or anything. But because there's no shallows about either, it's pretty difficult. Come on. So slow underwater, it's really annoying. Alright, get up before you die. One thing I do like about Just Cause though, all the secrets and stuff, they usually are pretty easy to find. Anything that you can interact with kind of flashes. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Let's have a look over here. Okay, dude, no worries. Ooh. Yeah, because there's no shallows, you see, by the time you get down to the bottom. You're nearly dead. Cool, dude. If you haven't played the DLC yet, the story's pretty cool on it, and the weapon's awesome that you get with it. Definitely worth downloading. A little underwater bridge bit thing here. See if we can get onto it or into it. Insurgent activity No, this one doesn't have a door on it. It's the other kind of thing that's got a door on each side. The DLCs, no. No, I'm dying. I can't even turn my camera. My game just glitching out. Won't let me turn the camera for some reason. Yeah, no. I think if you download it on one account and you've got Just Cause on another account on the same console, I don't think it lets you. I've got two accounts on my PlayStation, and DLCs and stuff I can only play them on my main one. But to be fair, the only reason I'm saying that's through Rocket League. I'd bought a couple of cars on it, and when I do multiplayer with one of my friends, when he comes round, it doesn't let you use the same cars. No, again. Yeah, did you not know you could customize it? You get a flame one, but as far as I know, I haven't figured out a way to change it. Once you get the Bavarian wingsuit, you can't use the flame one anymore, which is a little bit annoying. You can also customize your parachute as well. You can't really see it on mine, but I've got the flame one as well. Right, so on that one there's nothing. We're gonna have a look on actually no, I haven't done that one yet. So if we go that one and then that one, we'll save these bottom ones for another time, because there might be some around there as well, because there's that many things. So yeah, we'll do this little one and then that one up there. Yeah, it's a little bit annoying. Same with this one as well, though. I got, I think it's called the Reaper Mech. That's a microtransaction thing as well. And I can't play with that when I go on a different account. Yeah, it's a bit annoying. You can turn it off, though. If you go into your finger, downloadable. You can go back, so you can put the Bavarian wingsuit on, or you can go back to your flame. So you can change it. It's just you can't have the flame picture on it as well as being able to use your jetpack thing. Nice. I can't get mine to, I don't know why. So when there's no shallows about, it's difficult to know when to look. Just because by the time you get to the ocean floor, you're kind of dead. Let's jump in just randomly and see if we can find a shallow bit. Nope. Yeah, I can use PlayStation Plus on the other account, but I have to be signed into my main account at the same time. If I'm not, so if I'm just let someone else use my PlayStation and they sign into my other account, it doesn't let them go online. It just says that you need PlayStation Plus. It's weird. So again, I doubt there being anything under here just because it's a little miniature base. And the fact that you can't see the ocean floor makes it a little bit more difficult as well. What's that? That's some random dude drowning. It's alright, dude, I'm drowning too. Path Mike can get out. No, I can't. So close. Ah, I've already had the free trial. I got it when it first came out on PS3. And that's when I set both accounts up. So on that one, there was nothing apart from a dude that had fell overboard and started drowning. So luckily, we've kind of landed on the base that we were going to go to next anyway. But again, there's no shallow bits on it, which is a bit annoying. Have you not seen it? I'll show you now. If you haven't seen it, it looks pretty crazy. How do I swap? There we go. There you go. It's a beam from the sky that destroys everything. Yeah, I did. You have to go to... Where is it? It's on one of these little water bits up here. I can't remember which one. Yeah, I did that one ages ago. I can't remember what the video was called, though. It's like Smoke Monster from Lost. Right, let's get under the water and see if there's anything down here. To be fair, I think I've covered all the Easter eggs that have been found. I haven't sort of come across anything. And I'm on YouTube quite a lot as well, looking for different sort of stuff. Just randomly when I'm bored. And I haven't seen anyone else put anything on that I haven't found yet. I think the only Easter egg that I haven't covered was the dress Easter egg, because I didn't get it. I know the island where whenever you flew over it, your plane went down. The smoke monster's cool though. You kind of hear it, but if you turn back and chase it, it kills everyone that's there, and you can follow it through the jungle as well. So it's not just like the noise, which a lot of people thought it was. So again, on this one, there's nothing there. Cool. On Just Cause 2, I've not played that in ages. One of the first ones I found on Just Cause 3, Easter egg wise, I think it was the morph suit man that's sort of raving at night time. That one's pretty cool. Right, so nope, we've covered, have a quick look now. So we've covered all the top bases. We've got the ones at the bottom left to do. But like I say, to be fair, I'm not expecting to find anything. The only thing that we have found was those kind of obelisk things down here. And there was two shipwrecks, one here and one over here. But yeah, I'm going to do another video maybe tomorrow. Possibly Monday next week, and we'll check out these bottom ones. But like I say, to be fair, I'm not expecting to find anything. But I am going to end the stream here, guys. I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, a like would be awesome, and don't forget to subscribe. And Jake's Pop Gaming, cheers for chatting to us. It's been awesome. Cheers for watching, guys, and I'll catch you next time.